Alrighty then, good afternoon there, everybody. Silver Dragon here, coming at you with some Unreal World. You asked for it, and I'm bringing it to you. So, we're going to be playing this once again. Now, we're going to start a new game here in a second. Now, a few things have changed since, well, the previous time. Well, a lot of things have changed, I should say, since the previous time I played the game. We now have to be more careful with killing villagers. We can't really bring them out into the wild anymore. Hire them, bring them out to the wild, kill them, and then sell their meat to the back to the people or something like that. They take offense to that kind of thing now. Stealing was put in a while back, so if you take something from their village, you have to pay for it, or they, it is considered theft, and they will hunt you down, give or take, or your reputation will fall pretty badly. Now, when creating a character in this game, for anyone that's never really done it before, my suggestion, I would go with the custom one. That's what I do. Enter a name, Silver Dragon. Pick something you want to do and stick with it, essentially. If you want to use a bow, I would generally go with the Owl Tribe. They're pretty good bow hunters. They've got decent hide working and stuff like that. They are lacking in things like trapping. Their trapping skill is incredibly low, so if you want to do a lot of trapping, they're not too balanced for that. If you want a really strong character, it's usually good for melee or throwing spears and stuff. I believe the Kalmlin, some of that, like that, are really good at that. Those who live in the Kamo, or Kalmo, either way. If you want to do fishing, of course, the Seal Tribe, obviously, would be great for fishing. We're going to try with the bow character, though, to start off with. So you really do want to try and focus your skills on something. You don't want to try and jack of all trades everything, or it really doesn't work out too well. Let's go with male. I got quite a few more images here now. Let's go with this guy. I do want to start off in spring, give us a good amount of time to winter. I usually do suggest starting in spring. Now, here we get to re-roll our character's initial stats. Depending on what we get here, we will get tweaks to our actual skills. Now, you want to, if you, depending on how many times you actually want to roll this, it's really good to get this last body type at the very right side here, because that is essentially gives you the ability to carry more stuff. Now, certain tribes have a greater chance of having a bigger body type. Looks like this tribe now, the Owl Tribe, has an average, probably mid body type. So it doesn't look like I'm going to be able to get a really strong body type. Now, something like this wouldn't be that great because his strength is down to nothing. So that'd be freaking terrible. There used to also be a phobia meter as well that you would have. I definitely don't want my speed to be low. I'm hoping to get some a decent mid-range kind of stat here, but no, so far it's been pretty terrible rolls. I don't want to re-roll this like all day long though, so I'm gonna have to go with something here soon. Oh god, that physique. If it wasn't for that physique, I probably would have gone for that one. Okay, mid-range physique. Everything is decently high. Intellect is high. Will is really high. Height and weight is good. So this is our physique allows our total carry weight. So you really do, if you're gonna be carrying a deer on your back, you're gonna want a decent what the hell? Weight set. Either way, we do start off with two random rituals we can do. Looks like we got really, really lucky here. We got the Hunter's Incantation, an incantation for successful hunting, very good. And the Oath of Iron, used to enchant iron weapons to be more powerful in hunting or in battle. I believe spears used to be considered iron weapons, which are javelins, which was kind of funny, and you could use this to make them really, really strong. I don't think it works like that anymore, but hey. The thought is the thought that counts. Maybe if I had like iron-tipped arrows, it might be included in that, but I don't think it does. I should mention as well that I never did achieve like complete expertise in this game. I was adept enough that I could survive really well out in the woods and such. But anyway, now the first we have 5 points we get to spend in all these additional options here. Our skill set that we just acquired beforehand, our strength and everything, got applied to this. So we get to decide where we want our extra 5 points. Now, obviously, I want the first of my 5 points to go into, oh wait, not crossbow, into bow. So we're now an expert bowman. Next, I'm probably gonna want stealth, although you do raise stealth fairly easily over time, being being really talented at stealth is going to help us early on. Tracking would also be tempting, same thing for survival. Yeah, let's go tracking. Tracking, survival, and I think hide working. So we get really good quality hides. Now, it really sucks that our building is incredibly low. That means it's going to take us a really long time to build things, like build ourselves a house or a cabin out in the woods. But so be it. Same thing for timbercraft. It's going to take us a really long time to cut down trees. But at the very least, we're going to be really successful hunters. So if we have to rough it in a tent in a very small cabin, then so be it. I am generally happy with this setup, yes. So we're really focusing ourselves to be a hunter here. That gives us the skills we need. Same thing, if I were to try and put like a little point into fishing, I would be a little adequate at fishing, but I wouldn't be too mind-blowing at it. So I'm really focusing on being the hunter. If you try and go all over the place, you tend to be very unsuccessful with everything. So yeah, let's go ahead and approve that for now and hope for the best. Now it's generating up our world. Now, when it comes to trapping as well, I did say they had some pretty significant changes here recently. Essentially, when you placed a trap before, it would check your quality of the trap and the bait and whatnot. I'm not sure actually if you had bait, but regardless, when you built the trap and set the trap, it would check the quality of both of those, and it would spawn and sort of light animals accordingly into the area. That has been changed quite a bit. Now let me toggle the cultural locations. Now there's a lot of different places you could like to potentially go. I like to go somewhere like right over here, somewhere with a lot of water, a bunch of rivers that I can possibly trap prey on, and also it's near the Kalmo and the Kiesi. So I'm gonna go ahead and re-randomize my starting location. You can see there's a little dot here, there's a little dot that keeps warping around, is my starting location. So I want to get somewhere in this general area here, if I can. I wish I could just actually place my starting location, but nope. That's not too bad. That's not too bad, actually. We'll go with this one, I think. Let me turn off the cultural. Yeah, that's not too bad. We got a lot of rivers and stuff. No big lakes, but all in all, it's not too bad. Because generally, I like to build my house, if I can eventually, if I can get a raft, I like to build my house on an island. Because it keeps us safe from any of the hostile enemies, keeps all of our animals in check, so we don't have to worry very much at all. Now, I need to eat, enter this world and play, so let's go ahead and eat. Now we get to pick our starting scenario. The Unreal World just starts us in the middle of the wild with very little, essentially. The village, again, starts with very little outside of a village. Runaway slave. We have pretty much nothing, I think, in that case, for that one. The unfortunate hunting trip, which is probably what I'm going to go for. Your father lies dead on the ground, with the beast who killed him is still present. This way I can get a bow initially, hopefully. If I'm lucky, I'll get a bow. If I'm not lucky, then, well, shit. The Lonely Settler, you get yourself in foreign ground with two unfinished colleges, which is not too bad. Hurt, Helpless, and Afraid is probably the most difficult of them, I would say. You start off wounded, left for dead, and struggle to survive in the wilderness. So that one's really a tough one. Traps and trapping for those that want to become a trapper and really do a lot of that. If you pick the Seal Tribe, want to be a fisherman, this would be the one for you, obviously. You get an extensive fishing equipment start following your path as a fisherman. So you get a fishing rod, a couple of fish traps, which are really nice. Abandoned trap fence, an old trap fence in the wilderness. I have not actually played that one nearly enough, but it would actually be a really good start as well for a hunter. Abandoned camp gives you some basic camp materials, an axe, an actual lean-to, a bunch of logs and stuff, a couple of basic tools. Agriculture, again, there be robbers. You encounter a band of ruffians in the wilderness. Oh, this is like escape, try and run away. Not all who enter are lost, or not all who wander are lost. You set out to the unforgiving wilderness with a four-legged companion. Now, that four-legged companion is fairly random. It could be a dog, which is amazingly useful. It could be a sheep, could be a cow, you don't know. But let's go for the unfortunate hunting trip. I do wish to start with this scenario. Finally, you get to choose whether or not you wish to engage in the campaign. Now, engaging in the campaign gives you a lot of interesting free stuff if you do it. We have Living in the Wild, which is the basic campaign, and then the advanced campaign. Or these are, well, no, I shouldn't say campaign, these are just tutorials. cuff, or you can just go straight to the Unreal World for free gameplay. You're just released into the wild. I kind of want to go for some free stuff, because it does give you a basic fishing rod and some other stuff like that, a little fish to eat, so it helps you to survive initially. But you know what, I'm going to go with just into the Unreal World for now, and hope that I'm not going to suffer too horribly. Now, the interesting thing, though, is I can activate that tutorial at any time. So I can decide any time that, okay, I just want to give this a shot. I almost should have enabled it, just because it's been a while since I've played this, so I'm a little out of my depth, as it were. There's my poor father. Oh, father, why? Oh, they did do that, didn't they? Let's see here. Let's see if I can remember how to pick this stuff up. Yeah, oh, you're not lucky. We're not lucky. Shit. Ah, it blows. We got a spear, a hunting knife, a full set of fur, which isn't too bad. Got a hair, fur, and a cord. That's not too bad. Take all of them. Okay. So in other words, I used a comma in order to pull this menu up here to loot where it was below me. And now enter. Or not enter. Enter selects it, then space confirms it that we've picked all this up. Now hit W to wield. What do I got? No, I started off with a hunting bow and 8 arrows. Nice. A rough hunting bow. Not the best in the world, but hey. Now, usually the thing that killed us is a bear, so we gotta be very careful. Well, I think in this case it might have actually been a wolf. Now, I could cut up his body and possibly use the meat. Let me hit H here, though, to start hiding. Just so I can look around and see, potentially. Because I saw there was something around near us. If I'd actually looked at my inventory, I could have shot it. Now, our sneaking is pretty good, so our chance of actually encountering something and that happening is a little lower. Okay, I don't think I'm going to find anything right now. So let's go ahead and go to the main map here. Now, I can look around, move around on the map here using the num keys. I'm using 4 and 6 to turn. I can use 7 and 9 to turn in degrees, like top right corner, top left corner, so on and so forth. But the 4 and 6 will actually move between each one, like forward, top left, left, bottom left, so on. And then you use 5 to pass a turn and 8 to move in a direction. Now, let's quickly hit F6, see where I'm at. I'm in the big blackness, apparently. C will pull up the cultural menu so I can see where they're at. Now, roughly, in one of these squares here, you're roughly going to find a village in the center. So somewhere around this area, I'm likely to find a village. There's also a river or a lake or something around this area. So I think I'll head down here, check out a nearby village, and see what we can find. Now, I should mention there are two versions of this game. The first one right now is free. You could just go to the main website and download it. The second one is $5 on Desura, and you get, I think, another 15 minutes of interesting, like, local music, essentially. This is a coniferous forest. Or coniferous. Cough, either way. Either way. Now, you can use trees to kind of see around the area. It helps you see animals, it helps you just spot the terrain, and it will help us locate this village. Now you can see there's a really nice river over there. I believe those are rapids. Could actually be a ford. Might be able to cross over that. I'll have to check it out and see what happens. I'm not seeing anybody right now, or any villages. Ah, I'm going too far this way, I think. These swamps also help you look around and see there's anything around. Oh! Let's move down. No, I wanted to do tracking. Skills, S and T. Damn. Skills tracking. I know I saw that thing, though. So there are animals around here somewhere. I think I saw an elk, if I'm not mistaken, was what that was. But it's not showing up anymore. Now, usually if you spot them like that on the world map, you can run over to them quickly and it will pull you in right near them, giving you the chance to get a quick shot off on them before they run away. And then you have to track them down and see if you can finish off the job. But I guess I wasn't too lucky this time around, because I got there and they had already moved on somewhere, and they weren't even, I couldn't even see their tracks by using their tracking skills. That was a little bit lame. Okay, where the hell is that village? I must be going like completely the wrong direction or something here. To have missed them so completely, I must be just doing a horrible job tracking them down here. There we go, nice big wide view of the area. Oh, there's a small little, I don't think that's a village, more of a settled area. It's a small collection of huts. Let's communicate. So shift C, I think I did, or just C, I can't remember. Either way. Greetings. I am Silver Dragon of the Owl Tribe, mighty maiden. Good to know you, stranger called Silver. Back to chat mode selection. Do you have any items to trade? Got nothing to trade. If you like the goods around here, you just pick one up and we'll talk about it, okay? I'm wondering where the... looking for a village. Settlement in the northwest. It is a few kilometers away. You can walk there in half an hour. Thank you. So, I can actually look around the village, see if there's anything of interest. And if there is, I can potentially pick it up. So we have a bunch of turnips and beans here. So that would be for... God, I'm trying to remember some of these controls, though, now. Mm-hmm. Skills, yes. Look in direction. Look to a direction. X. Pick up from adjacent tile. Ah, there's 9 dried elk cuts, a bag of beans, and the tribesmen. Ah, I see. Now this guy, I believe, is a hunter. No, he's a woodsman, actually. Do you have any animals to buy in his place? We do not sell any here. Okay, no problem. That is a shame. One of the main things I usually liked to buy in this game was a dog. Dogs are really... or at least used to be really, really nice. I don't know if they have changed much now. As I noticed the last time I played, my dog's being a little bit less successful. Here we have a nice little cabin here. But there's nothing of really interest here that I can see that I want to buy. What do we have in here? Oh, it's supposed to be their storage shed. Yeah, we got a... This is where they store their seeds. So they now store large amounts of seeds in baskets or in boxes. More, the heavier seeds will go into the baskets, whereas the smaller ones like turnips will go into the... There we go. Ooh, we got 11 roasted bear cuts, a sickle, which would be really good for... Cannot walk into the fire. Smoked burbots, no thank you. So they really have a lot of food here and a lot of, what the hell is it called? A lot of food and a lot of seeds, but nothing I'm really interested in too much. This is a rowan tree. I believe there's some special, the rowan tree here specifically I can use for something. I'm just trying to remember what. I think the bark might have been used for tanning. Let me try something here. Skills. Timbercraft. Peel bark from a tree. Wow, it's taking a lot longer than I thought it would. Getting one big sheet of it. Cord. Is my various amounts of food that I have right now. So I have one thing of bark. Now, I'm not 100% sure. I know one of these trees is special for something, but I cannot for the life of me remember what. So they did say that the other village is just a few kilometers to the northwest. Oh, nice. We found a mountain. Those are really useful for seeing long distance. Oh, a settlement comes into view up ahead. So we finally found it, I think. Where the hell was it, though? Oh, there it is. It was off to the right. Derp. Derp. So I'm a little bit hungry. Quite a bit thirsty, though. There's usually a pond in each of these villages. Oh, lovely. We have the, I believe this is a new item here as well. Yeah, it's the sauna stove. It used to be, the sauna had a fireplace in it that was used to cook things and such. Now it's actually a sauna stove instead. So it has its own unique item. Let's go ahead and talk to the elder here, the sage. Do you have any animals here to buy, good sir? We don't sell any animals here. Do you have anything to trade? Okay. I'll have to look around and see what you got in this village then. At the moment, they don't really seem to have any shops here. Oh, here we go. We got something interesting. A bunch of fur. Arctic fox fur. So Arctic foxes now actually have a greater chance of showing up as well, which is interesting. Bear fur. Very, very, very valuable. Bunch of dried bear cuts, a wooden shovel. I think I can make one of those, though, so it's no sense in me buying one. I should mention as well that tools like that are much more commonly found in villages now. They actually seem to stock them, basic tools, a lot better. Now, what do I have and what do I need? I have a woodsman's axe, really good. Hunting knife is good for carving up the bodies. What else do I really need? I could sell my broad knife. I do have a skin, which is empty. I need to fill that. And a fur. Actually, I don't really need all that much, surprisingly, from them. Wooden bowls I can create myself. Rough footwear. Yeah, there's not too much in this village. I was kind of hoping for a dog, and actually, even if I had found a dog, they're so expensive that I likely could have sold pretty much everything I have on me, and it would have been enough. Fresh human tracks. Greetings, small child. Or not child. Where's the next village? There's a settlement in the west at the region. Man, I don't even know how to pronounce that. I'm not even going to bother. It's a few kilometers away. You can walk there in an hour, half an hour. It is one of our villages, okay. Or one of your guys' villages. Alright, so let's take a look at... Let's get out of here for a second. Ooh, let's see what we have in here, though. We got a wooden tub. That's actually one of the things I would like to have. Because the wooden tub is capable of containing a very large amount of water. Or milk, potentially. I wonder how much they would take for that. Yeah, let's try and buy this wooden tub. I wish to trade. I want to pay off my debt. What of my items would you prefer in this trade? I would rather not give you a single one of my arrows because I need them really badly. Again, I don't want to give you my spear either. Would you take my footwear here? think again. Of course he would. How about this hair fur? Let me think again, though. What's the weight of the hair fur? Really low. Let me try this fur hood. It has incredibly... There's not too much to it. Do I have a hood, though? I may wish to keep it for myself. No, I have a leather cap. No, screw that, then. Yeah, let's offer the fur hood. Okay, that's more than enough. That's more than enough. That's a deal. Take it. Take it. Now, I could have offered my arrow. I'm not too sure how easy it was to make them anymore. I can't for the life of me remember. They also stack up these logs here now, like finished planks and stuff like that you can buy from them. All right. Wait, I forgot. We have to look around the village here for this. Drink from natural source. Yes. So we're drinking from that. Let's go ahead and eat, which is now E or shift or capital E work. Eat the roasted bear cut, because that's going to last us the least amount of time, because it's roasted, not smoked. Activate the skin. Fill with water. Milk is amazing. If you can eventually get enough skins together to buy yourself a cow, milk is amazing. Now, you can see that the skin of water is now six pounds. Whereas the tub of water is 12, so we were able to carry a lot of water in the tub, which is great for milk especially. Like, if you get some milk, it makes a great way to store it. Whoa, again, this is what happens when you use the 7 keys rather than the 4 and 6 keys. Okay, we're now out in the wilderness again, so let's go ahead and look around a bit. Get up on a nice high tree here. Not too bad. There's a lot of interesting locations around here. See, that's a nice, that's kind of an island I would almost like to live on, just because it's connected to a really large river. It doesn't seem like there's too many rapids near it. It'd almost be a really good place to put some fishing traps as well, if my fishing skill wasn't absolute crap. Well, it's something you can build up over time. So, I'd really like to get myself a raft. I think I can actually make a raft. Well, I think I prefer a canoe to a raft, vastly. But, you know, we use what we got. We use what we got. Now, this would be a really nice place to put a trap fence, if I'm not mistaken, because it's a land bridge between these two areas. So, animals got to go through here. So, I'd definitely like to cut that area off and turn it into a nice trap area if I can. But, feeling a bit hungry. Yeah, the main issue is just finding ourselves our initial bit of prey. We do need to, fairly early on, find ourselves a deer of some sort. Whether it's an elk, a deer, a moose, it does not matter to me. Or even a freaking, even a wolf I would take at this point. Either way, we've got to find some source of meat to sustain us. And I can't seem to see anything right now. There we go. Want to get up in these high trees so I can see a vast distance around the area here. Got another field down there, which are like plowed looking fields, so we do have a village. And animals do can typically go near villages as well. Goddamn, I just wish we had been able to take a shot off that one elk we had found previously. That's what's killing me right now. That's not too bad of a view. Oh, I think this is a mountain here. Should allow me a great deal of view around the area. Damn. An owl of some sort. Another large mountain here. So I can see there's a lot of the very tall trees around here, but that's not going to help us out too much right now. Oh, there's a nice hill. Oh, big mountains now. Oh, so we're too tired. Yeah, we're too tired to stay on our feet anymore. Let's eat a little bit. Oh, wow, I actually managed to... Now I'm going to have to remember how to sleep properly. run. Yeah, Z. capital Z, I should say, as rest. I usually like to look for the large marshes. They tend to have a lot of wildlife roaming through them. Let's drink from our skin of water. Now, it takes a lot of meat to sustain us, especially if we have an animal with us, a dog or something like that. Like, dogs are really useful to help help hunt down animals, or tire them out, essentially, is what they do. They engage them and they help slow them down for us so we can catch up and finish them off. Now, this was a bit too effective for a long time, so I'm not sure if they nerfed it or not. There's the other village. I could still potentially trade a lot of my equipment right now, like my clothing and stuff, for food. If I have to, I would rather not. But you gotta do what you gotta do, almost. Eat some rye bread. Alright, thank you. Let's head more south here. Got a big river here. Or a big river, almost a little lake, I would say. Oh, there's one. Tracking. See what I mean? Freaking trolls! Now suddenly they're magically not there again. I'm not seeing any tracks in the area. That's really annoying. Scanning. Scanning. Let me try tracking a couple more times. Around the area. Hoping to see something here. God damn it. They never used to troll me that much. I mean, if I see one, I'm usually fast enough to get to it quickly and to take advantage of it. But this time right now, it's just, yeah, not happening. I don't know if they're just really skittish or what. But holy hell. It is not going to be easy to acquire ourselves a elk, it seems. Man, at this point, I would almost tangle with a freaking bear. Just to get some basic source of food. Bollocks. Damn, so they've definitely made things more difficult. Can't see shit. I actually haven't even gotten any random encounters yet, which is a little odd. Usually I at least get a few, but hey, what can you do? Oh, believe me, Wolf, if you actually showed yourself, I would freaking hunt you down right now. Another village. Well, it's actually just a settlement more than a village, but hey, it is what it is. I am running low on supplies already. Damn it. Usually by about now, I'd already at least bagged one, or at the very least managed to try to hunt one down. You know, get into the actual map and start tracking them. But I don't appear to be that lucky right now. Scouring the area, see what I can find. Oh, there we go. Nice, beautiful view of the area. I am weary, though, so I'm about to pass out soon. That seems like a nice spot. Alright, let's go ahead and sleep. You saw something move in the distance. Shit, I can't remember how to get up. I can't remember how to get up. That's unfortunate. U is get up. And prone would be, well, lay down. Let's hide. I thought they also increased bird populations as well, but I haven't seen anything yet. Might be more efficient for me just to actually walk around that area where the deer was at from now on. Anytime I see one, or an elk, anytime I see one, I should probably just get down into the area and just look everywhere for sign. All right, let's sleep. Okay, very hungry, very thirsty. Let's get back to the world map, enter, and look around. More disappointment. Nothing so far. So yeah, the next time I spot one of those guys, I don't care if it's telling me that there's nothing there. I'm looking around the area and see what I can find. It's weird though, I should be able to find, especially with the skill I have, I should have been able to find some tracks leading somewhere. It's definitely odd that I found nothing every time. I can see quite the distance, but I'm not seeing any animals. Oh, there's one. Well, I don't believe you. Oh, great, now I'm trapped behind these woods. I know they're around here somewhere because I just freaking saw them. But yeah, this is being really trolly because usually what would happen is I would move up to where I saw them. It would get me, like, you've spotted a deer or something, you've spotted an elk, and then I would pop, like, right freaking damn close to them. But that's not happening anymore. I don't know when they changed that, but that's kind of screwing me. I'm not seeing any tracks whatsoever. Or maybe the spawn just isn't properly working, and it's just, you know, the image is showing up, but there's not actually anything there. Is potentially what could be happening there. Now, there is actually a zoning kind of area going on here with all of these different places. So, essentially, it's all tile-based. So, each tile, you can actually go into like a gap, like this one right here. I can go completely up, completely down, as I desire. And I won't be stopped by any trees. So, it's a gap between each tile. Oh. Black grouse cooing to the west. No, I don't want to talk to anybody. Oops. Okay, let's fire. He seems to notice our hideout. Throw, so T to fire this weapon. Aim for the body. He fleed. I'm trying to grab this damn arrow, but it's not letting me. Now, on the plus side, I keep trying to use F, kind of like Cataclysm, to fire, but it's not, that's not going to work. Oh, he missed. Wield the next arrow. On the plus side, yes, I have failed to really take on these guys, but I might have found some deer tracks. Fresh elk tracks leading south. So yes, I can finally fucking track down that bastard elk who keeps eluding me. So this seems to be the new way to do it. You have to go around the area, kind of like how I did. They're fresh. Are you shitting me? Have they still not gotten the fucking archery systems working properly? Because, dear God, that was just a fucking miserable miss. Like, the bird was within 2 feet of me. There's no way in hell I should have missed that. Damn, it was my arrow. There it is. That's why I hate fucking hunting down small prey, because they're such a royal pain in the ass to actually fucking kill. Tracking. Fresh elk tracks heading southwest. I could potentially go to the actual main map and then go like one large tile southwest and see if we can pick up the tracks again, but that would also give me the possibility of losing the animal, and I really don't, after finally finding them, I do not want to lose this animal. Now, they typically are going to keep going in roughly the same direction. So even if you sort of start getting lost, you should be able to locate them fairly easily. Southeast. Ah. Continuing south. And this is also increasing my skill in sneaking as well, as I'm slowly making my way down like this. Unfortunately, every time it's important, there seems to be a bloody branch away. Now, right here, we can see there's a lot of freaking tracks. This makes things really difficult for you. But on the plus side, it also means that there is a lot of deer. So it's not a single elk. It's actually multiple creatures. Some fresh elk track heading southeast. When we get close to them, we're going to start hearing sounds from them. Southeast. There's the tracks right there. So it is a long process to frickin' track these little buggers down. It's not something that's going to just, you know, zip by. Very fresh. Oh, we're starting to get closer. So we are now significantly closer to the enemy. Yes, the enemy. Oh, fuck. I swear to God, if I scare one of them off by freaking hitting a branch just as I spot them, or just as I get within range, I'm gonna be so ticked with myself. Now the elk are a much, much larger target. So if I miss them with this bow and having my skill that high, then F-bows, damn it, F-bows. Gonna go back to spears. Spears are where it's at. Because there was something with accuracy and bows that was screwed up for like the longest time. And I could have sworn that they fixed it, but I'm not 100% sure if they did. Very fresh leading northwest. Let's just keep going southwest-ish. Yeah, here we go. Oh, fucking one of these. See what I mean? As they get, as they collect together, it becomes really, really difficult to tell who's going where. So this is where you can easily lose one of their tracks. There we go, we found one pair of tracks, very fresh, that is heading off here. Again. Oh, wait. No, it's gross. Gross. A gross. Oh, God. See what I mean? This is ridiculous now. Because I think they're... I'm not even 100% sure I'm on the right track now. Because there are at least about three or four deer. Or elk, if not more. Here. And they're all kind of coalescing into one area. And then making it really, really difficult for me to track them. So I can't tell if this is somebody trying to juke me here, just going around in freaking circles, or if it's actually going to lead me to a deer, so. Or an elk. Cough. I pray that it does, because dear God, this is taking a while. It's almost a bit discouraging going for such a long time following tracks and then just not locating. Wait. Okay, just another bird. Southwest, very fresh. Northwest. God damn. I swear to God, every single time I hear that freaking branch break, I just want to fucking smack the character or something. It's like, dude, don't make any goddamn noise. What the shit, my brother? You are screwing me. Okay, a nice big wide open area here. Very, very easy to... Oh, and then that happened. So you can see there's at least two of them. Oh, fuck. With the same bastard going around in circles. Yep. Nope. See what I mean? This is so difficult tracking them. And especially if they remove the ability to just drop on a deer like that. Like we used to, then goddamn, we're in trouble. I've had very fresh tracks for quite a while here. I may have to track this thing all the way into the freaking night. Is how redonkulous this is. Wait. Oh. It's a wait. I guarantee you almost this is going right back to that giant pile of footprints that we've passed previously. They all like to seem to coalesce in one area, run around in a big circle just to throw off hunters, and then flee to God knows where. Okay, where the hell did you go? Northeast. There we go. Every time I encounter one of those, it's just one of those elk circles, as I call them, or bear, whatever the hell. Elk, deer, whatever the hell. Either way, it's just such a kick to the nads.
Because it makes it so difficult to track the little buggers down. Considering how long now that I've been on Fresh Track, I'm actually a little surprised that I haven't heard at least anything from them yet. See, they're going in every freaking direction now, it seems like. They're not slow animals, so... Okay, I'm gonna stop hiding. At least until I get closer to them. Oh, fuck, another coalition of tracks. Yep. Luckily, I quickly found the right trail. Southeast. I think this is it right here. Yep. Continuing to head southeast. I could start running, but that'd be a very, very bad idea. So he had to go all the way around here, I think, to get around that section of trees. Yeah. Tracks continue on. We've been very fresh for I don't even know how long now, so... Let my stomach rumble. Anticipation for the hunt. Again, another coalition of tracks everywhere. Gotta look around here, see where the heck the exit path is. I can't tell, though. Oh, fuck. Damn deer are fucking with me. They're very fresh, they're numerous, and they're mixed, which means I can't tell shit. Wait, what was that? My only hope now is to walk around the area and pray that I find additional footprints. Oh, it's a black gross. Ugh. I already wasted... Well, I didn't waste the arrows shooting at it, but we didn't hit shit. Yeah, he fleed. I think I might have found the tracks. Finally. Yes, I found the tracks, finally. Let's see. Growing crowberries. Let me move that out of my way. I almost want to run for a little bit just to try and catch up. Oh! Alright. There it is. We finally, after all that, after like 20 minutes of tracking him down, we finally found him. No, I don't want to step into the water. Screw you. can't tell where he went. Oh shit, there he is. Narrowly missed it. No, for the last time, I don't want to dive into the fucking water. Unfortunately, I probably lost that arrow. Shit. And any fucking trap. Oh, wait. Nope, black gross. God damn it! All that goddamn works to blow it in the end. I got no tracks, I got nothing. I'm hitting every fucking branch apparently in the goddamn swamp. Shit. There we go. Finally found some more fucking tracks. Oh, I think these are tracks going the opposite direction. Yeah. These are tracks basically going this way. So I found him again, but he ran away. Because I fucking hit a branch. With all my masterful sneaking skills, I still hit a goddamn branch. I'm doing my best here. Shit. If they get back to the freaking woods, my likeliness of actually managing to get any of them is just going to fucking drop like a stone. Fuck me. Screw you, sneaking skill. You suck. Fuck, they're in the woods. And it's not even proper track because it's still going northeast, so it's... Oh, fuck. This is like the goddamn Deer Myers, I swear to God. Fuckers are like just coming in from every direction and completely boning up my tracks. Like right here. Once you get into a pile like this, God only knows where the hell they're going at this point. I can't even reliably go and find a single select point of track and follow it because of how freaking many deer there are here. Shit. At this point, I could try for the world map and see what happens. Yeah, seems to be a fresh track going in the right direction. Fucking black gross is driving me insane right now. It's like you travel for like a ghost for a long distance, and then the moment it's needed, you're screwed. Bollocks. No, thank you. The problem is that the deer or the elk, either way, are naturally inclined to herd together, so eventually you could be following a single deer, but he is going to meet up with a group at some point or another. And then this happens, and you're screwed. Very fresh, heading south. Fuck, there he is. Like a goddamn shadow. I gotta be very careful. I need to plan my turns very well here. I'm not gonna get shit. I'm gonna be freaking tired out before that damn thing is. This is why I like dogs, because the moment I spot one of them, I can immediately sick the... Wait, what was that? I can immediately sick the dog on it, and it will run up to it, harass it until it runs out of stamina, and then it's much, much easier for me to catch it. I see no tracks whatsoever. Oh, fuck me. You pesky son of a... This is not easy at all. This is like an adventure just to bag a single freaking elk. Wait. Fuck. Ah, jeez. Pesky little bastard. Is he just so high strung now that he is just flipping out at the tiniest breeze and running away, or what? Because, my God, this is ridiculous. If I actually manage to freaking catch this thing, it's going to be a damn miracle. And you can see they really like to circle back on their own freaking tracks as well, which screws me over even further. Because then you're just going in circles all day long. This is killing me. This is absolutely killing me. Definitely gathering up somewhere around here. Okay, that's enough of that shit. For a split second, I spotted him. don't think he can move from that. He's trapped somehow. Yeah, he's trapped. That opportunity does not come often. Okay. Okay, got him. He's fallen unconscious. Fucking got insanely lucky. I got insanely lucky there. That he actually got freaking trapped by all of that. No freaking way. That took so long. So long to do. Holy God almighty. Skin the animal. First step you gotta do when you finally, after all that fucking time, manage to track the bastard down, is skin him. First thing you gotta do. And then you have a victory meal and drink. Next thing you gotta do is butcher them, so... B, continue. Now you gotta make sure to skin him before butchering him or you waste the hide, which is fucking horrible. You never want to do that. Alright, let's take a nap here then. Okay, so let's drop. Okay, drop all of it then. Drop all of them. Now, what we want to do. Oh, let me wait a little bit for my fatigue bar to go down. Okay, I need to find, this actually might work well here, skills, woodworking. You can see that tracking has a little diamond beside it, so does stealth. That means it's actually increased its skill recently. Timbercraft, I believe. Fell a tree. And select the direction. So now we have 4 slender tree trunks, more than enough. Skills, survival, so SS. Wait, what? I guess I was swimming now. What is survival? V. SV. And you want to cut branches and twigs. Say SVC. Now, with all of that, skills, V, I want to build a shelter down below. I need 20 spruce twigs, which I should have down below me now. Now, I am tired, so I may have to sleep before doing all this, but let's eat again. Smoked elk cut. Now, what I want to do next is I only have one cord on me, so I need multiple. So, I think Z? What was that my crafting? No, M? M for make. Also, I accidentally picked up this slender tree trunk, so let me drop that. Although I may use that later for a fire, so I'll put it right here. Okay. Next step. M. Or no, I'm serious. That's move. Okay, N. That's not it either. Where is craft? I can go into the menu and do it, but there should be a way to do it. There we go. You can also switch between the pages. I should mention. Where, exchange weapons, apply, drop something, eat something, wield something. Repeat order. Ah, capital M. Okay. Utility items. We need to make cords. Let's make 5. Let's make the maximum amount of cords we can make. Now, in order to make cords, we need to use 2.5 pounds of cloth. So we use the hair fur that we had on us. That'll give us the 0.5.
And we'll use this linen shirt for the rest. Oh, we need a little bit more. Those trousers works. Now, knife, this will take us a bit of time. Now, cords are used to bind meat together in the early spring, and I think winter, was it winter or autumn? I believe it's early spring and late autumn is when you can dry meat. Now, you can only do that until summer. And once summer comes around, it's too humid, I believe, for the drying to work. So you have to do smoking and other preservation methods instead, which are quite a bit more difficult to do because you need like an actual little small cabin or something to do it. So you really need to get as much meat as possible in the beginning set up. Now, let me pass some time here. Let some fatigue. Get rid of some fatigue. Eat some more dried stag cuts. Okay, now let's pick up the 66 elk cuts again. Now, the reason why I built a shelter is you need a structure to do this with, essentially. So, skills, need to go into cooking. And we want to dry for preservation. Now, each cord can hold 19 meat. Is it 19 or 18? I better check this up. Check this out quickly. Let me check the fact page. Quickly, to the wiki. Tying equipment made of 0.5 pounds of cloth and a cutting weapon can be used in any item of tying equipment used for smoked, drying food. Okay, let's look for drying food. This page does not exist. Please wait. Okay. Well, I'll just have to say it as I remember it. Essentially, each cord can hold 19 meat, give or take. I think it's 19. Could be wrong. Was it 11? Fuck, I need to figure this out here because it's something really goddamn important. Hunting advice. Eating and drinking. God damn it. Mm-hmm. Ah, here we go. Smoked food. Yeah, 10 plus 9. Each cord is able of to hold 10 plus 9 meat. However, if you were to try and use two cords, you'd only be able to do, I believe, it'd be 10 plus 9, and then the next cord would be only 10, and so on and so forth for any concurrent cords. You have to do one batch of 19 at a time for this to work properly. So, I want to select the raw meat. How many I want. I hit space for number. 19. Place to dry it, which is next to our shelter that we just built. A tying equipment, which would be our cord. Done. Now I want to hit R, I believe, to repeat that order. 19. Space, select the cord, space. So we're basically tying 19 batches of meat together, hanging it on our shelter to dry in the weather. And that will allow us to preserve this meat over time. Now I'm extremely tired, so let me try this one more time. I may take quite a bit of cords to do this. Now, it takes 25 days to be able to dry this meat. Now, we're going to need a lot of food between that then and now. So, I like to clean off the hides and stuff, maybe go to a village, grab a bunch of cooked meat or something, and sell clothing to them in order to pay for it. That would help us live for a while longer while we're waiting for the meat to finish drying again. Then hunting repeatedly and repeating this kind of situation is what we want to keep doing. Now, there should be a way to make a custom map marker now, which we could not do before. How much meat do I have left on me right now? 9 elk cuts. So now that I don't have enough, I'm going to quickly... Let's have a drink. Oh. Not from our water tub, then. Okay, let's go ahead and sleep for the night. We wake up nice and vigorous. You to get up. Now, let's finish butchering our deer. Or elk. Cough. Too bad I can't, like, carve off the horns. I believe this one was female, because it doesn't have any horns. But it'd be nice if you could, for various trophy reasons. Drop. How much do I have here? I have a lot. Holy crap. Holy crap, do I have a lot. No, drop my water for now, then. Alright, all my dried food. Oh, I shouldn't have done that, actually. Oh, well, too late. Yeah, I can no longer move. So, in that case, let's drop... Let's drop 50 of those cuts. That'll just barely give us what we need to move. Okay, now, obviously I'm going to need a lot more cords than what I currently have here. Activate. So, skills, cooking... Drying. I guess I'll keep those 9 cuts I have on me right now. 19. Yep, I only got 3 cords left. I'm gonna need a lot more cords. Repeat. Now, a deer hide in and of itself, or an elk hide, is more than enough to create a lot of cords. I don't have my freaking thing on me, so I can't do that. Alright, I'm about to fry up some of this stuff soon, cook it, and give me something to eat to keep me going. Now, God, what else do I want to do right now? Let's pick up the tub of water quickly. Activate. Or just a Q, I guess, would work better. Okay, now there was a swamp nearby, so what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to tan the hide, or clean the hide, using the water I have in my tub. Usually I'd like to do it near a lake or something, but I think I might just do it using the water in my tub. That way I can quickly go back there, fill it, and all should be well for that. I hope they never add disease for water. Types like you never drink water from a swamp kind of thing, because otherwise I'd be screwed. I'd be so screwed. Okay, anyway, shift M, let's make some more cords, make another 5 if we can using the trousers and the footwear. Barely enough to make it. Getting really hungry here, so I better hurry the hell up. This is gonna take us 2 hours to make 2.5 hours to make 5 cords, goddamn. Alright, again, skills, cooking, because that would repeat the cord option if we did it again. 19. I may have to take some of this into town and trade it for some preserved stuff. Because I don't have enough here to last me. Grab all that. Repeat. Even if I have to sell it to them at a disadvantage for me, it'd probably be a good idea. So I'll use what little I have left for the cords. Actually, you know what? I think I'm going to call it with that and leave the last cord. That way I have 9 cuts of meat that I'm just going to cook up right now and use for my own personal food kind of thing. I have 17 cuts of meat that I can bring in and trade. It's me, skills, SV, nope. That's build. SV, make a hole in the ice. What happened to, there we go, build a fire. Repeat the order. We got a fire. Now, skills cooking. Roast, 9 cuts, all of them. Should be complete in half an hour. Wish I had an indication of my time. Where's my actual wait button? I'm trying to remember that now. Goddamn, been a while. Rest. There it is. So it's right next to the zero key. Cancel. We don't want it to burn, so gotta be very quick on canceling that. Let's eat our roasted elk cuts. Now, F6. Kind of wondering how I could leave a map marker right now. So we're right next to these guys. So I think I might actually go join them. Now, I see. Now my camp here should qualify as a map marker, so I don't have to stick around here. But before I go, skills, hide working, clean the skin. I need, oh no, I need 10 pounds of water. Let's move away here for a second. Okay. Skills, hide working. Nope. Clean the skin. We now have a cutting weapon in the water, so we're just, you know, scraping away the fat and all that kind of stuff. Cleaning it really nicely. It takes a couple hours. No, I'm not going to abandon the task when it's almost done just because of a freaking bird. Crazy. Activate the skin. Fill it with water. Activate the tub. Fill it with water. Eat. Roasted elk cuts. Alright. Now, the hide is now tanned. Or tanned. Cleaned. Cough. Let's go back to our little campsite. We should drop right where we left off. We did. Okay, now next step, skills, hide working. I need to cure the skin. Well, you don't really need to cure the skin unless you are not doing this process right now. If you're, you know, wanting to cure it for a long period of time, then you can do that so you don't have to worry about tanning it immediately. It's a good way to do that, but we're tanning the skin right now. So first off, we need the skin. We need another 10 pounds of water, so crap. I think I have enough, though. And we need 2.12 pounds of tanning material. Now, a good reason why you want to tan immediately is because you also get elk fat, or fat from the animal that you have skinned. And you can use that to tan the hide. So we're going to use the water in our bin to do that. I'm ready to drop now. Should be completed. This step should be completed by late evening, but I'm really tired, so let's eat some roasted elk cut. And go ahead and sleep. Wake up feeling hot. Let's get up. This should be pretty close to ready now. X direction. Still being prepared. In that case, let me see what I need to make arrows, because I am running a little bit low on arrows, because I did use up a bunch of them on trees and random things that just decided to get in my way. So, Shift-M, weapons, arrow. Let's just say one. What does it take to make one arrow? I need a branch, a knife, 3 feathers, and a tying equipment. Okay, that's for an actual arrow. What about a primitive arrow? Primitive bow. Blunt arrow. I don't see any primitive arrows. This also requires feathers, so I need to hunt freaking animals or freaking birds. I guess there's actually the need now to hunt these little wankers down. Let's see if I can hear Black Gross. All the tracks for the deer are now old and useless to me, for the most part. Open mire. Hoping to see an indication of sound somewhere. Just going around in a circle. Hoping to hear some birds that I can murder. Nope, don't step in the water. I don't feel like getting wet. For no reason. Now, it's really dangerous to be shooting your arrows out here just because it makes it really difficult to recover them. What do we got here? It can be harvested after a few months. Crowberries. One of many berries. Nope, not hearing a damn thing so far. I could follow this little gap between the terrain to locate something. It's actually a way I like to travel from place to place every now and then. It's just to go between these gaps. That way any random animals that happen to cross my path, I can try and take a shot at them. Let's go up this way now. So far, I'm seeing absolutely freaking nothing, or hearing nothing. I guess I should have taken a shot at those birds when I had the chance. I didn't know now that we needed... Oh, shit. Yeah, this thing is useless to me for hunting them. Damn. Finally found one, but it got away. Even if I tried shooting it with a bow, though, there's no guarantee I would have hit it, even at that range. Which is freaking annoying. I mean, come on, if I'm this skilled at a freaking as a bowman, I should be able to hit a freaking bird when I'm 5 feet away from it. I don't care how goddamn tiny it is. I should be able to hit it. Let me try something quickly. Gather up a couple of rocks. What I remember with birds hiding in trees is that you can whip a rock at the tree and potentially knock them out of the tree if you're lucky, without wasting any of your precious ammunition. I got lucky though finding that guy. I doubt I'm gonna find something anywhere near as good now. Nope. So I guess I'll have to leave hunting down small prey to next time then. Damn. Alright. How's our hide doing? Still being prepared, so let's sleep for a bit longer. Eat some of our roasted elk cuts. We do gotta get out of here soon, though. Yep, it's done. So we pick up the tanned hide. Next skills, hide working. Continue tanning the skin. Need another 10 pounds of water, actually. Let me go back over here temporarily. No. Activate. Fill it. Thank you. Back. Enter. Okay. Again, skills. Hide working. Continue tanning the skin. Use the water. This is just cleaning it after the initial tanning process. But it's going to take another couple hours to do. So this is going to be one long-ass beginning video for this, to be honest. But this is something that really takes a while. Alright, it's midnight. It's going to be ready at noon. Let's eat. Quench my thirst. Alright. Let's see if we can find one of the other tribesmen here. Oh. Some fresh wolf tracks leading southwest. I'll totally have myself some delicious wolf. Hour old. Screw it. There we go. It's like usually when you spawn in like that near an animal, they're really close just north of you. Yeah, very fresh tracks. Oh, there he is. Got him. Wield. Trying to run after him now. Okay, stop running. I got him in the shoulder, so I did at least wound him. No, don't step into the damn water. Unfortunately, I didn't wound him enough to bleed him, which would have left a really nice trail for me. Oh, shit. Growls in pain. Now, wolves are like bears in a way. They have the good potential to attack me rather than just run away. Okay, I think I got it. Let's grab some arrows. Damn it, nothing to pick up. Unconscious, grievously wounded, big wolf. Use the edge to its neck. Skill thrust. It's finally dead. Okay. Let's go ahead and grab my arrows. Nice, all three of them are back. Skills, hide working, skin the animal. It's a harsh wolf skin, what can you do? Can't make good out of bad. Butcher. Nice, we got what we got. Nope. So again, skills, hide working. Let's clean the skin quickly. Skills, hide working. Begin the tanning process. Now, depending on our skills, we can take a harsh skin and actually turn it into something decent, so we might be lucky for that. Oh, shit, we actually put it here, though, didn't we? Well, shit, let's eat. I'll just have to chill here for a moment. Nice. Grab that. Activate. Okay. Go on the map. Let's go back to where we were at, or back to our camp, where the other tan, or the other hide is tanning. Cough. English. Skills hide working. Let's go ahead and tan the skin again using the water. That's going to take a while. Fucking hearing the birds. Now, I think, actually, I should probably call this here as the first video, because there's just too many things I need to still do, and I don't have the time to do them. This video is going to be 2 hours long. So I'm going to call this here for today. Hopefully, y'all enjoyed. Next time, we're going to see if we can find the... Where is it? Something was cooing in the distance. Capricali is cooing in the east. So I want to see if I can hunt him down.
Because if I can get their feathers, if I can butcher the feathers off of them or pluck the feathers, whatever the hell it does, I'm hoping I'll get quite a few. That is like the main ingredient I need to make more arrows. So I have to hunt down a bird soon. Now we do have... How many was it? We have 44 wolf cuts. Ooh, we have 17 steel elk cuts. I need to get... I think before I attack the bird, I need to immediately get to town and start selling these cuts because they're going bad. Actually, you know what? Let's go to my map here quickly. Let's see if I can find a village here quickly. It should be right around here somewhere. Oh, there's one right there. Oh. And then we run into a stag. And then we run into a stag. Shift T. Remove this. Get the knife out of my inventory. Wield the arrow. Okay, so the thing does not... It still doesn't see me. But... We're going to leave that till next time here. So let me double check here. Make sure I'm not going to screw this up. Injuries, wounds, yada, yada, yada. Quit. And save. Okay. So will I manage to shoot that stag and score my third kill for the beginning of this LP series? I guess we'll find out next time. Haha. Now, I was actually intending to even then go to the village and trade that stuff off quickly, but then that stag happened. So, you know, that's just, what can you do? So, yeah, next time we're going to be seeing whether or not I'm lucky enough to bag myself another stag. Oh god, I don't know what the hell I'm going to do if I do, because I don't have enough carry capacity to carry any of the stuff. I'll probably have to wander around the area quickly, make another tent in the area, that way I can come back to it shortly after I go to the village. And hopefully I can finish the tanning process on the other stuff. I'm probably going to take my clothing, rip it into cords, so that I can start drying that meat. Because getting a stag and an elk this early on, hell yes. Hell yes, that'd be amazing. So yeah, hopefully y'all enjoyed watching. I'm going to try and make the videos a little shorter next time. We just spent so much time just tracking down that freaking elk. Oh, that was an adventure in and of itself. Oh, jeez. Anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. Have a great one. See y'all next time. Dragon out.